Good morning and welcome to the Lakeside Viking News. I'm Braden Webb and it's Monday, October 26th. Let's begin with a brief Lakeside High School announcements. Have you heard? In-person voting is still in Georgia. If you're 18 years or older and registered to vote, you can find the nearest polling locations and hours near you, right here. Election Day is November 3rd and registered voters may also submit an absentee ballot now until Election Day. Looking to take on a leadership role? Dance Marathon is a program raising money next semester for Children's Healthcare of Atlanta and needs your help. Leaders will help plan, organize, and advertise for the end celebration. To apply, go to @LakesideSGA or @LakesideDanceMarathon. Both of those are on Instagram. Any boys interested in trying out for the boys basketball? Please contact Coach Bassett for more information. The LAA's Latino Youth Leadership Conference is an inspirational and high-energy experience featuring motivational speakers, workshops, and college and career fair opportunities to connect with fellow students on university campuses. It is open to students, parents, and school staff. This year, the Latino Youth Leadership Conference will be held virtually on October 29th with a kickoff event followed by a college fair on October 31st, 2020. You can register right here. Now, for a moment of silence. Thank you. Now to Deanna with the news.
What's up, Lakeside? I'm Deanna, and I'm back with your current events. Multiple aides to Mike Pence have tested positive for the coronavirus. CNN reported that at least three of his staff have tested positive in recent days, while the New York Times reported that at least four tested positive. Pence and his wife, Karen Pence, tested negative Saturday, and Pence will maintain his schedule without restrictions, according to his office. The virus continues to spread rapidly throughout the U.S., surpassing 83,000 positive cases in a day for the second day in a row. Hopkins reported more than 900 additional deaths Saturday and almost 42,000 new hospitalizations, according to the COVID Tracking Project. The Senate is set to take a vote Sunday to advance Judge Amy Coney Barrett's Supreme Court nomination, paving the way for a final confirmation vote, which will most likely take place Monday evening. The Sunday vote would be to break a Democratic filibuster on her nomination. It is expected to succeed with the support of most Senate Republicans who hold the majority in the upper chamber and have pushed ahead with one of the quickest nomination proceedings in modern times. With few exceptions, Senate Republicans quickly lined up in support of Barrett after her nomination by Donald Trump, and the judge is on track to be confirmed despite opposition from Democrats and the final wishes of RBG. Only one Republican, Susan Collins of Maine, is expected to vote against the nomination due to concerns that it is too close to the election to consider a nominee. Now, to the very first episode of the Lakeside Viking News Halloween special.
Actually going trick-or-treating?
Yeah, of course.
Isn't Halloween canceled this year?
Why would it be canceled?
Because of Corona?
What's Corona?
Are you okay? Have you been living under a rock?
No, I live in this house.
Right.
Well, candy's not gonna eat itself.
Did you hear anything I just said? There's not even gonna be any kids out there.
Thank you.
That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Have a marvelous Monday.